Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Tay. In this video, I would like to share 7 tips that I wish I knew when I started using MacBook. These tips seem very basic, but as a user switching from Windows to MacBook, these tips make my life a lot easier and productive. So without further ado, let's start the video. Tip number 1 is closing the app permanently. When I started using Mac, I saw that even when I closed the app, The app is still running even when you hit the red button on the left side of the application. You can see the app is still running in the dock. There's a little dock at the bottom of the application. If you want to close permanently, go to the name of your application on the left corner of the menu bar. In my example, it's code. Click code and then quit Visual Studio Code. There's a shortcut for that is Command Q. Now the app is closed permanently and you don't see the dot anymore. Tip number 2 is previewing files. When we normally preview the files, we double click on the file, and then when we finish previewing, we click the close button. This is one way, and there's a better and faster way to preview files, which is using the shortcut space. To preview file with the shortcut space, use the space command, and then when you finish previewing, click the space command again. It's convenient and it's a lot faster. Tip number 3 is organizing files. When you go to Finder or Desktop, you will see the files are organized. You can organize them manually by moving around the files and the folder. It works, but it's time consuming, not efficient, and in my opinion, it's not that even organized. So to organize automatically, you can use Stack. To use Stack, go to Finder or Desktop, use the two finger on the touchpad, and then select Use Stack. You can select what kind of stacks you want, such as kind, name, text, etc. It's more efficient and look more organized, and it's also automatic. Before moving on to the next tip, I would like to ask you to subscribe to my channel if you want to learn more tips like this. Tip number 4 is multi-touch gestures. You can use two fingers on the touchpad to enlarge web contents. Use four fingers to swipe at your touchpad to see apps in your desktop. Alternatively, you can use F3 and then swipe down with four fingers to go back to your app, or you can choose the app that you want to switch. Tip number 5 is separating desktop or making multiple desktops. For example, let's say you are following a YouTube tutorial to learn coding. It's pretty slow to switch apps in one desktop. For example, you're switching using the previous tips, using the four finger swipe app and then chain manually. Instead, use the multiple desktop. If you have multiple desktop, you can switch left and right using the four finger gesture on the touchpad. To separate multiple desktop, use four finger to swipe up your touchpad, and then on the right side or the top, you will see the plus icon. Click plus, and then you can press the button as much as you want the desktop to be separated. You can also rearrange desktop by manually clicking around the desktop. So in that way, you can easily move around. You can have multiple desktop and you can easily move around the desktop. Tip number 6 is recording your screen. In Mac, you can record your screen without using external software. To record your screen, press Command Space and then search QuickTime Player. Then go to Advanced, select New Screen Recording. Then you can choose the full screen or the selected frame. Then press Record to start recording. To stop the recording, you can press the Stop button on the menu bar. And here we go, you get your screen recorded. Tip number 7 is shortcut in Note. Note is one of the apps that I use the most. From scripting my video to taking notes, I only use Note. So knowing some basic command to edit the text on Note can make editing text a lot easier and faster. And the first command is to make the text bold. You can use Command B to make the text bold. To underline, you can use Command U. To make italic, you can use Command I. Alright, these are the 7 tips I wish I knew when I started using MacBook. It's not essential to know these tips, but knowing them and using them make my life a lot easier, and I would like to share with you guys. If you want to mention additional tips or if you know any useful tips, kindly let me know in the comment section below. I would like to see them. Alright, hope this video is useful. If this is useful, please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. And see you in the next video. Bye bye.